By the end of this video, you are going to know how you should configure your computer settings to run QLab during a show. When I was searching around, I was surprised to see the sheer lack of content on how to properly configure your machine for running QLab during a show, since that is one of the most important things to do. Since if we didn't, we could run into issues like the computer going to sleep, the screensaver showing on our projection output, or even the performance of our computer suddenly decreasing and starting to messing things up. Thankfully, the very helpful people at QLab have created an article that outlines the needed steps, which I will link below. Today, I'm going to cover what steps to perform, why we do them, and at the end of the video, I will show you how to use the workspace that QLab provides that will automate most of the processes for you. For some of these tasks, we're going to need to use the terminal that is built into macOS. This application is located in the Applications folder inside a subfolder called Utilities. Once you have this open, we're going to be pasting some commands in there. You will notice that for some of these commands, it will prompt you to enter your computer's password. And this is because we will need to be running some elevated commands, and the macOS essentially wants to make sure that you really want to do this. Let's start with improving the performance of our computer. One of the reasons that macOS operating system is so easy and is always snappy to use is because it's doing a lot of indexing behind the scenes. Spotlight is the Mac process that indexes all the files on your hard drive, and it makes them easier to find in search. This can slow down our computer or make our workspace stutter or lag if Spotlight decides to index a file that we are using. To disable Spotlight, paste this command in the terminal, hit return, and enter your computer password. Another process that likes to index things is Time Machine. While it is a good practice to keep things backed up, you should not have automated backups active on your show machine. You can disable this at any time by using the command in your terminal. One of the most stressful or awkward things that could happen during your show is having your computer to go to sleep or having your screensaver show up on one of your video outputs. Since macOS has various settings for sleep, we will use this command in the terminal to disable the display from sleeping, the disk from going into an idle state, and preventing your computer from going to sleep. Another nice benefit of the Mac operating system is that it likes to keep itself updated. And some of those processes happen behind the scenes, without us even knowing. But in a show environment, we don't want this to happen. To fix this, we can run this command in the terminal to disable the scheduled updates. Many modern day applications like to sync all their changes to the cloud, which can pose an issue for us during our show. Everything could be running nice and smoothly, and then your Photos app starts uploading those vacation photos you took, and then all of a sudden your OSC commands start getting all wonky. Make sure that you log out of any internet accounts, and make sure that your internet backups are either disabled or set to backup only manually. iCloud is usually a big culprit when it comes to background syncing, since it does your photos, emails, contacts, messages, and many more things. Signing out of iCloud is a good practice to prevent any of these things from happening without you knowing. The best way to prevent things from syncing without your knowledge is to disconnect from the internet altogether. And personally, this is exactly what I do. If you depend on running network queues, such as OSC, it is always a good idea to use a separate Ethernet adapter and not using the Wi-Fi. If you plan to do video through QLab, there are a few additional things we need to do. First, we need to reconfigure our displays to have separate spaces. This will prevent the menu bar from showing whenever no cues are playing. To do this, we need to enter this command into the terminal. Then, log out and log back in to finalize this change. Since we don't want our desktop background to show, we need to black out our desktop. In QLab, we can do this by going to the Tools menu and selecting Blackout Desktop Backgrounds. And with that, you are now ready for the show. QLab also provides a very useful script that automates the things that we had to paste in the terminal manually. In the description below, follow the link to the QLab website and download their Prep and Restore workspace. This workspace contains two script queues. The first one will do all the terminal queues for you, excluding the ones that are only for video. You will still need to log out of any internet apps and stop external programmings from connecting to the internet, however. Once you are done with your show, you can use the second queue to restore your computer back to its original state. If you found this video useful, feel free to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to support the channel. And I will see you next time.